she had.
Oh, don't tell me she had to nothing. What's more important than burying your own father?
Tell you what, Sammy Joe, how about you go find the person you really want to yell at, and then you come find me. How about that?
Well, if you're so blamed smart, who is it that I really want to yell at, huh?
What in the world are you screaming about?
You all right, Sammy Joe?
Just the person I want to see right now. Nope, Addie, I'm not all right. Where the heck have the two of you been? Mama's been worried sick since she never showed up at the cemetery.
We had an errand to run.
Oh, you had an errand to run. You couldn't be bothered to bury your dead daddy because you had an errand to run. This is just like you, Harley. Always skipping out on the important stuff. But why should I be surprised? You've been doing this since you were a little girl.
Just let us explain, Sammy Joe.
No, Addie, I will not let you explain. And if you excuse us for a minute.
Right. I need to talk to you over the dope anyway. Can you handle this mess?
Every day of my whole life.
Yeah. Well, if things get too loud in here, I'll come check on you.
What kind of a dog skips out on her own father's graveside service?
I told you we had an errand to run. Me and Addie went down to his office to see what we could do to stop Uncle Doug from taking Mom's house.
Well, why bother? Just going to swoop on out of here tomorrow, aren't you?
You know, I've been joking about this for the past couple of days, but you really do hate me, don't you?
You know, Harley, the way I'm feeling right now, I don't think hate is a strong enough word.
All right, Sammy Joe. You've got me all to yourself. Let me have it.
All right. You want it? You're going to get it. Of all the nerve, 10 years ago, you lit out of here like a cat on fire. Couldn't wait to get out of this small town. Had to go live that big city life. Be that big city girl you always thought you were. You know, you're unbelievable. You broke Daddy's heart. Broke Mama's heart for all that matters. But that's the point. Never mattered to you.
So that's what you think. Do you think it never mattered to me what they thought?
It doesn't matter to you. You just get to do whatever you want, go wherever you want, nothing to tie you down, not a care in this world. Man, it must be real hard to be Harley.
You have no idea what
written on napkins is the most official, huh?
There's a coffee ring on your resignation.
Well, Doug, as your lawyer, I would like to inform you that the claim made by you is unsound, unreasonable, and invalid.
Invalid?
That's lawyer talk, but it ain't yours.
What's this about?
Well, the cute one right there?
Uh-huh.
He's my lawyer.
That's right. And as a lawyer, Doug, you do not own this land. Me and Harleen just into it.
I told you it was the poor man.
Doug, if you look here in your daddy's will, you'll see that he wants to keep it between his two sons in a joint ownership with full rights to the survivor, meaning that whoever died first, the land went to the other.
And that's why I get to do with it what I like.
Well, I know that's how you see it, Doug, but see, the state of Mississippi don't see it that way. Harleen and I fit into it. So, if we look here in the state of Mississippi's law book, you'll see that since you never occupied your half of the land, never did anything to take care of it, never developed it in any way, that you therefore is forfeiture of that land.
That's ridiculous!
Well, now your daddy's will's pretty clear about this, Doug. He wanted his boys to build homes on this land, to raise a family. He was big on family.
So was Matt Dewey.
That's right. And Dewey did build a house, raised his family, took care of the land. You never did. So according to the state of Mississippi, since you abandoned your half of the land, it is his. And according to his will,